In my mind, in 1948, the Israelis committed ethnic cleansing against the Palestinians. And I think the historical evidence proves beyond any doubt that the ideology, the strategy, and the policy itself can only be described as ethnic cleansing. I don't think there's any other way of doing it. We are now quite familiar with the term, and there are very clear definitions by the State Department, by the United Nations. And in my book, I show how especially the State Department definition of ethnic cleansing fits the Israeli operations in 1948. So I think there's no doubt that this is the only and appropriate way of describing what happened in 1948. The idea of ethnically cleansing Palestine developed throughout the years, in a way. It was first a very fluid idea and a very elusive idea from the 1930s onwards. And it's only when the British government announced in February 1947 that it is going to leave Palestine after ruling it for 30 years, that Ben-Gurion started to seriously contemplate the ethnic cleansing of Palestine. And he gathered a group of people, and through a series of meetings over a year, the idea developed. At first, they thought that they should only expel people from villages that acted against the Jewish community as a retaliation policy. But then they found out that that doesn't really cover much of the Palestinian population. And if this is not going to happen, the future Jewish state would not have a Jewish majority in it. And I think somewhere around the beginning of 1948, January 1948, they have transformed the idea that ethnic cleansing would be just a form of retaliation, and they started to actively plan the expulsion of the people, whether they acted against the Jewish community or didn't. And that's how it developed. The settlement of Jews in the West Bank and the Gaza Strip that began in 1967, I think is a part of a new phase of ethnic cleansing. One has to understand that the Israeli government in 1967 realized it could not repeat the ethnic cleansing of 1948, on the one hand. On the other hand, they also realized that they cannot allow these people to become citizens of Israel. So in order to find a formula that would, on the one hand, keep the people under Israeli control, and on the other hand, would not expel them, they needed to downsize the area in which these Palestinians lived in order to have a better control. And this, I think, is why the Israeli governments basically encouraged the settlement of Jews in the area.